The field of research that we do is electric propulsion. Sometimes we call it plasma propulsion. And a logical question is, what is plasma? Well, it's not what's running along your veins. That's a different kind of plasma. The type of plasma that we're talking about is actually a state of matter. Some people call it the fourth state of matter. You start with the three states of matter that we understand mostly, solids, liquids, and gases. That's a natural segue to understand what a plasma is. So you start with, let's say, a solid piece of water ice or so. It's solid phase. If you put energy into it, what's going to happen? If you put enough energy into it, it melts. It goes into a liquid phase. If you put more energy into it or you raise the temperature, it'll eventually boil and go into a vapor phase or a gas state. Now, if you put a lot more energy into it, what'll happen is that the atoms, the molecules, will break apart. And then even more energy, what'll actually happen is that the atoms, the individual atoms, will start breaking apart. An atom is nothing more than a nucleus made up of protons and neutrons. With, you can think of it as electrons, sort of a cloud of electrons floating around it. And if you put enough energy into that, what happens is that the electrons gain so much energy, they actually are able to break away and come free from the atoms. And what you're left with then is a free electron, which is negative, and then an ion, which is has been depleted of one or more electrons, which is a positive charge. To first order, what you can think of a plasma is a cloud full of positive and negative charged particles. This is a Hall effect thruster, and this type of engine would be used for anything from deep space probes to actually very large Earth orbiting spacecraft like communication satellites. The way a Hall effect thruster works is that we have a tank, which we're not showing right here, full of the propellant. And the propellant would be something like xenon or krypton, a very easy gas to store. What we do is we have a tube back here that injects the xenon gas in the back of this discharge channel, we call it. Then what we do is we would have normally a tube here, what we call a cathode, that emits negatively charged particles called electrons. You can think of this tube essentially emitting a series of lightning bolts, if you will, steady state lightning bolts. And what the lightning bolts do is essentially heat up the xenon particles to such a degree that it actually becomes a plasma. It's heated so high that it's a plasma. And once it becomes a plasma now, we're able to use the applied electromagnetic fields to accelerate that plasma. And we're able to accelerate the plasma anywhere from around 40,000 miles per hour up to about 100,000 miles per hour.